What's good YouTube, welcome back to the channel. In today's video I got to do something special, you know what I'm saying? But before we start this video, if you're new to this channel, do me a favor please right now. Get down there, click on subscribe, open your notification and don't forget to like on this video, you know what I'm saying? Hey man, today I dropped for you guys two videos, you know what I'm saying? That grind don't stop, you know what I'm saying?
Stop it. Get some help.
Never gonna stop, you know what I'm saying? The grind never gonna stop. So we're gonna do another video for you guys today. But before we start this video, I want to ask you guys, if you guys want to see a prank on my little sister, you know what I'm saying, or my mom or my friends, you know what I'm saying, let me know in the comment down below and I'll do for you guys any kind of prank. Just give me any idea and I'll do it, you know what I'm saying?
Do me a favor please, get out of here. Get out right here, man. Shit, I'm saying.
I'll do for you guys anything, you know what I'm saying? So, make sure you like on this video. Make sure you like on this video. So, let's get to this video. I don't want to waste your time, you know what I'm saying? This video is 7 minutes, so let's get to it. So, guys, into this video, we're going to react to the Islamic way of sleeping with your wife, you know what I'm saying? So, I never seen this video before. So let's see, man, how you gonna sleep with your wife in Islamic way, you know what I'm saying? Let's get to it. Click on like right now, you know what I'm saying? You might be gonna forget the end of the video. I always say
Lady,
that.
Go!
Let's go.
Istimta' is a mutual pleasure, and so both the husband and the wife are entitled to that. And I mentioned that traditionally in Sharia, it's considered a man's right at any time, and the reasons for that have to do with men being more prone to being overcome by their appetite. Mm-hmm. The Prophet ﷺ said that a woman actually has more appetite than a man, but the modesty is so intense in a woman that it protects her, whereas the man doesn't have the haya component as strong in him, and so it can become more dangerous for him. And so that's why. And then a woman, generally, it's once every 4 days. And if that is not fulfilled, then it can become grounds for a divorce. I mentioned also, I think, that if a woman complains to a judge about lack of sexual intimacy, then he can command the man to sleep with his wife. Mm-hmm. And this is not considered, Ibn Arabi radiallahu anhu said, it is not lack of modesty that a woman makes that demand. It should not be considered, because it's praiseworthy for her to want to protect her virtue, and that is a right. And so it's one of the maqasid, or the goals of marriage, and for that reason that she is not to be seen as an impious or immodest woman if she's demanding that right, if she's being neglected there. And just in terms of etiquette, the etiquette of the bedroom, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, don't go to women like a camel goes to a she-camel. And then he also said, send a messenger, which is what is termed in modern jargon, is called foreplay. And they asked him what that was. And he said, kissing and sweet words. So that was part of his teaching, was that women should be treated in that way. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said that he liked to adorn himself. I like to become ornamented for my wife in the same way I like her to do that for me, which means wearing perfume, cleaning the mouth, taking care of oneself. All of those are important, and they're the sunnah of both men and women. And then they should wear good clothes. They should take care of their hygiene, which includes cutting nails, keeping them clean. For a woman, things like braiding her hair, using henna, hair coloring, removal of body hair. And then for both man and woman, obviously removal of the underarm and of the pubic hair on a regular basis. And according to the sunnah, it should be done at least every 40 days. People are different on that, but it's a sunnah, and it's a neglected sunnah by some people, but Muslims should do that. Mm-hmm. And then disrobing, it's actually encouraged to disrobe, and you know, there's some other traditions where they actually, in the Orthodox tradition and some other religions, the woman's, you know, is supposed to be a sheet and with a hole in it and things like that. And I mean, Muslims don't have any of that. That's another religion, so there's nothing wrong with that. And then Aisha radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان يمص لساني, he used to suck my tongue. And that's related in a sound hadith. And actually, in traditional Chinese medicine, it's considered an actual healthful thing to do for the two partners to actually. There's an exchange of fluid, and it's considered to be a beneficial thing. And then it's encouraged before that act that they pray two rak'ah and seek refuge from shaitan. Allahumma jannibna shaitan. You know, keep us away from shaitan and keep shaitan away from what you have provided for us. And then no harm will come to any offspring if it happens to occur. And then also, especially for newlyweds, a man has to be sensitive to a wife's natural modesty and shyness and take time, because usually these are new things. And I think one of the problems with the modern age is because of films, people have seen things that in normal societies, healthy societies, none of those would be issues. Whereas in modern society, people have already seen more than they should. Yeah. And I mean, one of the things that my 10-year-old was at a library, and he came up to me and he said that there was some little girl over there that was really bothering him. She kept staring at him. And he didn't understand it at all. He was just kind of in a... And the thing about it is that traditionally little girls didn't, you know, they didn't do things like that until they got into puberty and older. And even then, most girls would be too shy and modest. Whereas now, there's the whole culture is teaching them to be immodest, yeah, to do things like that. So these are really bad signs for a culture or a society. And then in terms of pleasure, the entire body of both the male and the female is permissible to derive pleasure from and give pleasure to, with the exception of the rectal area. It's the Prophet ﷺ prohibited anal intercourse, and so that's something that, and he actually said some strong things about that, just about what type of people do that and things like that. So the next right is mutual inheritance. So shared rights are the right of inheritance between the spouses based on Quranic portions. Allah says, and you will inherit half of your wife's share if she leave no child. And if they leave a child, then to you the fourth of that which they leave after payment of legacies they may have bequeathed or debt. And to them belongs a fourth of that which you leave if you have no child. And if you have a child, then the eighth of that which you leave after any legacy. And part of the reason for the disparity is that when children are there, the children have a legal responsibility to take care of the mother. Mm-hmm. So it's important that the male, in all the inheritance laws, the understanding has never been that a man gets more because he's better or something like that. Nobody has ever said that in the history of Islam. Mm-hmm. It's actually seen purely in economical terms. A man's responsibility is more than a woman's. And there are a few situations in inheritance laws where women will get more than the male relatives. But generally, the male will get more. So, and the point is always understood to be that the obligations are greater upon the man to other people, whereas a woman, her wealth is discretionary.
Wow, man. We learned something new, you know what I'm saying? Something we didn't know. So if you are married, you know what I'm saying, don't forget to make dua too. Let me know what you guys thinking about this video, man. It's nice, man. You learn a lot of stuff you don't know about it, you know what I'm saying. So guys, yeah man, I love it. This video's nice, you know what I'm saying, for my future, you know what I'm saying. I gotta know, you know what I'm saying, I'm still single right now, so
doing the people. He needs some milk.
When I get married, so like this is gonna be like, you know what I'm saying, helpful, you know what I'm saying. So guys, let me know what you guys thinking about this video in the comment down below. And if you guys like it, make sure you like on this video. If you guys want to If you guys want me to post for you guys a prints or vlogging, let me know in the comment down below and I'll get to it. Make sure you watch the video, the previous video, I did reaction on, what was it?
Oh my god, I already forgot what. Oh my god, man. I'm sorry, guys, man, I already forgot what
I forgot what video I did, I just did, a couple hours ago, probably, how many hours? 5 hours ago. Yeah, I did a beautiful conversation of Musa and Adam. If you guys didn't see that, go watch it. Make sure you like on that video, too. And I did a reaction on, Weird Genius, Latin, Fitzara, Fajira. I did yesterday. Make sure you like it. And yesterday too, I did Sabian, So I did two videos yesterday, but not at the same time, After a couple of hours, after 10 hours, then I did another video, go watch it too, man. Show love. Let's get to 150 likes on it, man. You guys support the show love. What are you waiting for, man? I'm out. Peace. Up on the internet, I hit up all of they bitches and get them wet. Call her over, I hit them and send her back. Do it in silence, cause players ain't internet. No, oh, I